In today's wrap-up, according to the chairman of the Central Bank of Armenia, roughly $205 million are lacking as a result of loan payment. Armenia's Minister of Justice, Rustam Badasyan, reacted to the legal successors of the victims of the March 1 case statement. The restrictions on entering and leaving Artsakh due to the coronavirus epidemic are lifted. Armenian banks did not receive roughly $205 million due to COVID-19 pandemic as a result of loan payment holidays, Martin Galstyan, the chairman of Central Bank of Armenia, announced today during a press conference. According to Galstyan, Armenia's financial system has responded to the lockdown crisis quite flexibly, providing individuals and businesses credit holidays worth roughly $2.7 billion. He noted that credit holidays were granted to about 550,000 individuals and 17,000 businesses. Galstyan said that the general volume of lendings by Armenian banks increased, which were mainly agricultural and business loans. Armenia's central bank had forecasted in June a contraction of 4% of the country's GDP in 2020. Armenia's Minister of Justice, Rustam Badasyan, told reporters today that it is not right to tie the examination of the March 1 case with the whole process of judicial legal reforms. Badasyan was referring to the statement made a day earlier by successors of the March 1 victims and their representatives. 8 protesters and 2 policemen were killed during protests in March 1, 2008, following a controversial presidential election which brought Serj Sargsyan to power, backed by then-acting president Robert Kocharyan. Kocharyan, along with several other key officials of his administrations, are now charged with overthrowing constitutional order. The legal successors of the victims of the March 1 case denounced the trial as meaningless. They are complaining about the pace and permanent protraction and describing them as a contentless farce, as stated by the lawyer Tigran Yegoryan. Stressing that he had no comments to add about the March 1 case, Rustamyan nonetheless said that he had noticed a general tendency of court hearings protractions. The restrictions on entering and leaving Nagorno-Karabakh due to the COVID-19 pandemic were lifted. The restrictions were introduced on April 20. From now on, there is no need for permission to leave the territory of Nagorno-Karabakh, and the requirement of a PCR test, which was a mandatory condition to enter the territory, is now removed. The reason for lifting the restrictions is the sharp decline of COVID-19 cases in Armenia, the commandant of the emergency state in Nagorno-Karabakh, Jiran Mirzoyan, stated. The tourism sector of Artsakh, which is one of the key drivers of the local economy, was hit by the restrictions. According to a survey conducted by the Artsakh Tourism Department, in the first half of 2020, the tourism sector suffered a more than 80% contraction compared to the same period of 2019. In CivilNet Special, CivilNet interviewed Lawrence Brewers, associate fellow at Chatham House, an expert on Nagorno-Karabakh and the South Caucasus, about the July 2020 skirmishes on the Armenian-Azerbaijani state border. The July escalation is considered the worst Armenian-Azerbaijani violence since the four-day war of April 2016.
What we're seeing is this kind of dynamic of totalization of the conflict and homogenization of identities, whereby anyone who identifies as Armenian and Azerbaijani is implicated in a script of this conflict, a preconceived script, instead of being free to make up their own minds about what they feel about the conflict and ways out of it. So I think this is a very concerning trend, and I think it shows just how easily the dynamics can tip out of control for all parties.
Dr. Lawrence Bruce gives also his take on the current state of Armenia-Azerbaijan peace talks and his new book entitled Armenia's Velvet Revolution, Authoritarian Decline and Civil Resistance in a Multipolar World.